If two black holes collide in space and no one's around to hear it, did they make a sound? It turns out, yes, and we can hear them with the help of a supercomputer. That's right, folks, every few minutes, a pair of black holes smash into each other, apparently, which is something no one told me about until now, like it's not the coolest thing ever. Because when black holes collide, also known as black hole mergers, they cause ripples that travel through space-time. And this is what we call gravitational waves. As you may have heard, 2015 marks the first time we were able to detect gravitational waves, arguably one of the biggest astronomical discoveries of the 21st century and confirmation of Einstein's 1915 theory of general relativity. No big deal. And while there are some gravitational wave-producing events that are distinctly measurable, there's also what researchers call the gravitational wave background. This is basically background noise resulting from all the hundreds of thousands of gravitational wave-producing events, like black hole collisions, that we can't distinguish individually because our equipment isn't sensitive enough to discern them. We haven't even been able to detect the background noise as a whole yet. But new research is out from a team that's developing sensitive ways of listening to space that may allow us to detect it faster than we'd previously thought possible. And of course, they're using a supercomputer to do it. These researchers are using a particular kind of computer simulation called Monte Carlo simulation to produce a kind of practice background noise that they can listen to. With a new and unique search strategy, they've shown that they can identify gravitational wave-producing events within this practice noise. Their new methods mean that they can perform the search with about a day's worth of calculation, whereas by the previously existing method, it would take up to 40 months to detect the same thing. And plus, the researchers say that their method is 1,000 times more sensitive than previous attempts. We're talking some serious sensitivity here. Gravitational waves that we can pick up produce a disruption in space about 10,000 times smaller than the radius of a proton, and that's the ones we can detect and distinguish. So this team is making improvements in detection, but not with the actual measuring or listening capabilities we've developed. Instead, they're working by improving data analysis and basically number crunching technique and capacity. Wizardry. It's wizardry. To speed things along even further, as of March of this year, the researchers have access to a new $4 million supercomputer, allowing them to search for this background noise for real, not just in simulation. And in the future, the researchers think that extensions of this work could be used to study gravitational waves that originated very far away, in both space and in time, potentially even letting us see and listen to gravitational waves left over from the Big Bang, which are currently hidden behind more recent events. So we don't know what the background noise sounds like yet. That's the goal. But the individual gravitational waves that are relatively close to us in space-time sound kind of chirpy. Have a listen. I don't know about you, but my takeaway from this is that computers basically could be our best bet at understanding where our universe came from, and that understanding how to work with them could help us look at the fabric of space-time, which will never not be the coolest phrase ever. Need more gravitational waves in your life? Then subscribe to Seeker and check out this video on how they could help us understand dark matter. And fun fact, gravitational waves vary based on the properties of the objects that smashed into each other, basically like a thumbprint of a unique space-time event. Thanks for watching. I'm Maren.